Hi, I'm Shravani. In this video, I introduce Intel's direct programming language, data parallel C++, and the terminology of heterogeneous platforms. This video will help you understand the basic blocks of a DPC++ program and the simplicity of compiling it to run on an accelerator. Data parallel C++ is a high-level language designed to target heterogeneous architectures and take advantage of data parallelism. It enables you to reuse code across CPUs and accelerators while permitting custom tuning. DPC++ is based on the familiar standard C++ language constructs such as templates and lambda functions. In addition, it incorporates SYCL spec from the Kronos group. Intel has established a data parallel C++ open source project to help drive broad adoption. We also work with the open source community to drive Intel's extensions into SYCL Next. Now let's take a look at the building blocks of a DPC++ program. Before talking about the code, I'd like to quickly go over the terminology of heterogeneous platforms. It consists of a host, which is usually a CPU. The host runs your application and offloads the kernels to an accelerator using an API or direct programming. Then we have the devices, which are accelerators executing the compute-intensive parts of the application. In other words, it runs the kernel. Together, the host and the device can make up a heterogeneous platform or platforms. For example, the CPU with the GPU can make up one platform. Now let's look at a DPC++ program which performs an addition of two vectors on a GPU. Step 1 is to include the language headers and namespace, providing the templates and class definitions to interact with the runtime library. Step 2 is to create buffers which will allocate the memory to store the data. Step 3 is to create a command queue for specific devices using a device selector. The device selector can be a default selector or a CPU or GPU selector. If the device is not explicitly mentioned during the creation of the command queue, the runtime selects one for you. However, it's a good practice to specify the selector to make sure the right device is chosen. For step 4, you can now start submitting the work to the device by calling the submit method and provide this method a lambda object. The next step is to create accessors to the buffer inside the lambda object in order to access the buffer data on the device. This provides runtime info about how the kernel will work with the buffer data. Step 6 is to then send the kernel for execution by calling the parallel for method to execute them in parallel. The code that is written in parallel for will be accelerated by the accelerator, which is a GPU in this example, and the rest is executed on the host. The results are copied to vector C at the destruction of buff C when the scope ends, and the data is copied from the device back to the host. We can see here, everything is written inside a single complete C++ program that is needed to execute the addition of two vectors on a GPU, unlike an OpenCL. Now let's look at the compilation flow of a DPC++ program. The DPC++ compiler toolchain is capable of compiling both host and device code into a single FAT binary with a single compiler command. To recap, DPC++ is a single-source heterogeneous programming model that will help you write portable code across different target accelerators. Watch the overview of DPC++ programming video, access Intel's open-source project for LLVM, and download the DPC++ compiler from the oneAPI toolkit in the links. Thanks for watching.
Hey! I hope you liked this video. If you haven't seen our other videos on the Intel Software YouTube channel, remember to subscribe, and don't forget to leave us a comment. Tell us what other material you'd like to see, and chat with other enthusiasts who watch our shows. See you next time.